What's up, guys? Noah here with the Car Guys. We're here today at the Giant Hand Tournament at Atlanta Games. And I'm here with my friend Jeremy Barnett. Jeremy, what did you do today?
I won this big card right here. It's a hand and it grabs a lot of things because it's huge.
What'd you play to win that hand today?
Ritual Beast JaJaJa.deck things.
Alright, let's look at it.
Here we go. Best card. Most valuable player within the deck. Draws cards, makes combos happen. It's real good. And then this card, you win.
You ever have that against like Clifford or any crazy matchups today?
Yeah, when he pays 8, I drop this, and then I set Fairy Wind and pass. And it wasn't good for him.
It wasn't good for him.
This card, that's a good tamer. She does the same thing, but the booty and the lettuce skirt. And then you want to open this every game.
Oh yeah, how often do you open that, baby?
Every game.
Pretty much. I opened that so much. I was like, normal summon, old man, bring another friend. And he did. And then she's sad. Look at her, she's so blue. She brings back something from the banished pile.
Are you going to post a video on YouTube and try to make this deck?
Petalfin. This gets rid of Decree and Unicorn and Winda and anything else that says, hey, try not to play Yu-Gi-Oh for me. But then you do anyway. And then you got Lightning Birds.
Alright, so you said you opened this card 2 out of 3 games. How often did you open these cards?
I didn't open that a lot.
No.
It was mainly the other bird that I opened. But like I usually just made it work. And if I didn't open that, Emergency Teleport's a real good card. Cause like this bird's real good. You search things.
Yeah, it's a bird deck.
Yeah, bird. We're in the nest. And then bump window, because we like the special summon. Real good cards. Dimensional Fissure. I opened this. People might think I was sacking. This, I opened that a lot.
How often did you open that?
So much. Should all players don't like me.
Giant hand, everyone. Anyway.
Should alls don't like that. 3 of this guy. Because he makes things happen. He's like, oh, you open bad. No, not really. And then when you almost kill them, and then you do, that's the best card. He just savaged that. What else we got here? We got some one-ofs. Book of Moon. Lightning Bolt.
Yeah, good cards.
Real good cards. You gotta play those if you're playing Yu-Gi-Oh! This gave me, every time I played this turn 1, it completed the combo. Every time. If I open Upstart, I opened Ambush and Seeds. Which leads me to the next point. Ambush and Steeds. You play this card after you play this card and then you just win. They don't play after that.
Especially when you have defense. Right?
Oh yeah. Things are just gone. And then we got one-ups. Giant Wave. There's this cool play you can do where they summon something and you defuse. And then you activate this card. And then you just kill their board and then you have a board still. It's real good. Thanks, National Champion, for teaching me that move. That's real good. Solemn Warning. Exiton sucks. So just play that card for that. And Denko. Denko's no fun. The best card. Just don't let them Solemn Warning your macro. And then Phoenix Chain. I don't know why I play this card. It stops them from doing things. Manju's real good,
I guess. Did you ever like wish this was a Breakthrough skill instead, like to stop Unicorn?
No. Because Kanahawk, he just kind of gets around Unicorn. I just don't like him being there when I go to attack with like the big lions. Yeah. So, what do we got next? Extra decks are fun. Dweller.
Yeah.
I never made that card. Exiton. I made that card like once. I made this card one time. It's real good. I think I put a construct back or something. Don't play this card.
Yeah, didn't make that card today.
No, sir. It'd probably be Giant Hand next time. I got one of those. Black Rose Dragon, because E-Telly Ghost Ogre blow up everything is real good.
Did that come up today at all?
No. It has before. It was real good. They were like, oh no. Ultimate rare. He negates everything. He's, this is what you kill them with. It's ridiculous. You bond into that, win. Okay, we're doing this benefit for the Pointy Warriors. Star Eater. You know how it is. Make this thing attack. Valk doesn't stop me. You're safe from card effects when this is on the field, sir. Dark Hole is no good. The Beast. This is the deck right here. This, you don't, everything in the white sleeves is real good, but like, without this card, you're just not gonna win. You wanna search the trap cards, and that's how you do that. He's real good. Side decks. Mystical Space Typhoon, Royal Decree, in game two. Bump that card. Space it. I open this card every time I slotted it in. I'm sorry, Shadal players. You just don't get to play Yu-Gi-Oh. I like Macrocosmos. And then that card actually won me a game today. This guy activated El Shadal Fusion first. And I was like, why you do that? Non-fusion area. And then Fairy wins. You beat the Cliffwarps, you know. Tower can stay in your hand. Denko kills you. You want no part of that. No part of that. Get that out of there. Thunder King, because who needs a search, you know? Not me. I'm just kidding, I search all the time. I don't know why I sided that card. Never drew it. Triple debunk. Because when they go Brio, you say, nah, man, you don't need to search that. Or Klaus. Or when they send Arclight. Or when the Shadal player tries to activate Construct and add Fusion back. Or anything in the meta right now at all. This card just kills them. BA kills them.
Anyway, Jeremy, congrats, man. It's awesome you won this. It's really, really cool.
Especially, I got a medal.
Yeah, it's especially cool that you won it with a deck that many people don't see is available right now. Once again, congratulations. And this is Noah with the Card Guy signing out.